my experience, what's happening now is increasingly the conversations between GPs is about demand reduction, risk management, case finding, instead of the language of what I call caring. And the language that I've just used is the language of the market. It's actually the language of health maintenance organisations. It's the language of preventing care before it's actually happened. It's the language of cost containment. My concern is, as these reforms move on, it's actually going to be increasingly that GPs are going to be having to use the language of the market. And really and truly what GPs want to do is they want to care for patients. And I just highlighted that at our national conference and again highlighted it in several other speeches that I've made. Well, that's very complicated. The only way CCGs can avoid that is by having the systems and structures that we currently have within a National Health Service. So, for example, PCTs being responsible for a contiguous geographical population with no capability of cherry-picking or cream-skimming patients. The moment you get that opportunity, then you will start picking patients or excluding patients. The only other way is to make sure that the bill that's going through absolutely, fundamentally restricts GPs or CCGs from co-payments, from deciding themselves what should be available on the NHS, i.e. through taxation. Now, if they don't do that, I fear, and it's already happening to a certain extent, that CCGs, or in fact commissioning support organisations, will become the HMO equivalent. And the whole point about HMOs is to restrict care before it actually happened, and there is a whole industry in that. There's a whole industry in case finding, in restricting care, because once care starts, once you refer a patient to hospital, it's almost uncontrollable. So CCGs, I think the only way is through making sure that you in a sense support what myself and what others are doing in making sure that the systems and structures that you work in provide a national, comprehensive, universal health system with no gaps and no possibility of patients falling through those gaps. This gets very confusing, and people often confuse what Bevan talked about, universal healthcare versus uniform healthcare. So what he meant there was, irrespective where you lived, you should be able to have access to certain treatments if they were available on the NHS. Now, it may be that they weren't provided in your area because your area might, for whatever reason, not be able to provide that. So it wasn't uniform, but it was universal. As far as I'm concerned, what is provided free at the point of use, i.e. through taxation, should be determined by nationally elected politicians. It's then up to local people, local services, to say whether actually we need that particular service in our area. Because, of course, in Cambridge, you're not going to need endless cataract operations because you're full of students. In Bournemouth, you probably don't need services such as STD services because you've got elderly care. So the decision must be made by government, but the implementation of those decisions, of course, is up to local services, local GPs. We can help with those decisions, and GPs and others do, by sitting on NICE and other bodies such as SINE, but fundamentally, GPs make big decisions in the consulting room, and politicians need to make big decisions in the House of Commons.